guys, so today I'm doing a Perrie Edwards inspired tutorial from the music video Move. Excuse a duber on my chin, but yeah, so I was requested to do this video, so I'm gonna go ahead and do it. So the first thing I'm doing is just applying my Benefit Porefessional all over my face to prime it for all of the stuff that's gonna go on it. Then I'm just using my Maybelline FitMe foundation stick, really covering that pimple spot, and then I'm just blending it in with a flat top kabuki. Now it is brow time, so I'm gonna go ahead and fill in my brows with the Revlon Brow Fantasy. And I'm just going to make them a little bit longer than they normally are because that's kind of how Perrie's eyebrows are. Then I just go over it with a powder to make it match my hair color better, and the pencil kind of works as like a glue for it to stick to. Then I'm just gonna cover this ginormous pimple and also just apply concealer to places I want to highlight. You want to especially highlight around your eyes because she has a really, really bright eye kind of look, and that's the look that we're going for. So just really conceal all the dark spots on your face. I'm using the Hard Candy Glamoflauge Concealer and just applying it with a brush and then blending it out with a beauty sponge. Then I'm just going to apply face powder, and I'm using the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder in Sandstorm. Then I'm just going to bronze my face up a little bit, sort of lightly contour it with my Prestige Illuminating Bronzing Powder and just a little fluffy brush. And then I'm going to apply a concealer over my eyes as like a primer for the eyeshadow. And then I'm just going to be using the Covergirl Exact Eyelights in Wild Greens, and I'm going to apply the three lightest colors in the quad, just kind of one after the other, just kind of blending them all together on the lid. And to do that, I'm just using the Real Techniques base shadow brush. Then I'm just gonna blend that out with a clean brush so there's no harsh lines, because she has very faint eyeshadow. And then I'm just gonna use this double-sided L'Oreal eyeliner to line my lash line very thin with the black side, and then I'm gonna smudge it out with this Real Techniques pencil point eyeliner brush and kind of wing it out a little bit. I'm gonna smudge it out towards the outer corner. And I'm going to take the white side and I'm going to line the waterline, as well as extending that underneath the winged liner. I'm also going to apply it to the inner corner of my eye, and by extending your waterline through the inner corner and the outer corner, it just makes your eyes look really big and bright-eyed like Perrie's. Then of course I'm just going to curl my lashes for mascara. This is going to make your eyes also look really big and open. Then I plan on wearing falsies, so I'm just applying a very light coat of mascara just to make my lashes darker to match the fake lashes. But if you're not wearing falsies, you can just put a lot of mascara on to compensate for that. But yeah, I'm just applying the Demi Whispies from Ardell. Then I'm just applying mascara to the bottom lashes, focusing mainly in the center, again, just to give a really bright-eyed, open eyeball look. Now it's time for the lips, which is really important, so I'm just prepping my lips with some chapstick, and then I'm applying the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk just to kind of tone down the color of my lips so that the purple color will show up better. And I don't have an actual purple lipstick. I find that they're pretty difficult to get your hands on unless you want to spend the money for like lime crime or something like that. So I'm just using a blue eyeliner as a lip liner for a base, because blue and pink make purple. And then the lipstick I'm using is like a magenta color, so when I add it over the blue, it really makes a nice purpley color. So then I just added in a fake nose ring to really look like Perrie, and I curled my hair with a straightener, and then there's the look. I saw her walking down the street. She looked so fine, I just had to speak. I asked her name, but she turned away as she walked. All that I could say was, tell me your name, I got a fever for you. I just can't explain, but there's just one problem. I'm a bit old school when it comes to loving. I ain't chasing you.